Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel. So today we're going to take a look at Adobe Firefly. It's recently released in beta and we've got a few options. I've done the text effects option in the last video, so I'll leave a link in the description. You can check that one out. But for this video, we're going to try the text to image generator. So this is kind of like Midjourney, Stable Diffusion, DALL-E, and the other ones that are getting around. I'll leave a link to the Adobe Firefly website as well. You might be able to get into the beta. If not, you can check this out once the beta is finished and it becomes open access. So to begin, we'll just go text to image. So click generate, and this will take us to the main page where we will enter our prompts. So at the bottom of the screen here is where we can enter our prompts. Now I'm going to try something interesting here. So there is another website called Lexica Art. So this website here is a great place to get some prompts. So it's using Stable Diffusion. So if we pick something from here, let's say this one, so image of a neon style. This gives us some prompts that generated this image and similar images. So we're just gonna copy and paste this one and see how close the Adobe one actually gets to this. So we'll jump back over to the Adobe Firefly, paste in the prompt. So that's the prompt there we copied from Lexica, and we'll click generate. Okay, so it's given us some interesting styles here, kind of similar. So on the right hand side here, we've got some options. So at the moment it's set to art. We've got none, which should give us a pure representation of the prompt, photo and graphics. So I'm just going to jump through and try these ones out with the current prompt we have. So none actually generates quite a cool prompt. Let's try photo. Kind of similar, less accurate, I would say. Graphics actually very similar to none, and we tried art in the first generation. So obviously at the top here, we've got some aspect ratios. We can check these out. Let's jump to widescreen. It's probably the most common. People will be using this for wallpapers and such. Okay, so changing to widescreen changed the style quite a lot. So we'll just leave it on this for now, and we'll try some of the popular styles here. So let's try digital art. There's a couple of good images here. This one's a little bit weird. And that one as well. Okay, so now we have color and tone. Let's say vibrant, lighting, dramatic, composition. Okay, this is interesting. So we get to choose the angle we're going to be shooting from. So let's go wide angle. Okay, so we've entered some variables here as well as our prompt style. We'll click generate. Okay, so it didn't really change too much changing the color and tone. Maybe we'll try something a little bit more interesting. So macro photography. Okay, so at the moment it looks like the composition, lighting and color and tone don't really make much of an effect on our original image. So we'll drop these out. We will go back to Lexica, copy another prompt, and we will see what we get. So back over to Lexica. Let's try something a little bit more realistic. Say this style. Copy the prompt, back over to Firefly. Okay, so we'll generate this again. Okay, so we have a issue here. I'm guessing it's gonna be probably... Okay, that's pretty weird looking. So that one are pretty decent. This one is totally messed up, but that's pretty typical for AI generated art. So we basically butchered our original prompt down to this, and whatever was on the back half was causing issues. Let's try test something a little more complicated. So, well, that's pretty cool. That's crazy strange, but definitely cool. Try to change the aspect ratio. Okay, so it's kind of annoying. It changes the entire image when you change the aspect ratio. So if you're going to do this, I suggest you set your aspect ratio first in case you get something great. So you've got an option here to show similar, options here to submit to the gallery, use as a reference image, and obviously an option to download. So we will pick, let's pick this one. We'll use it as a reference image. So options, use as a reference image. We'll bump this right across to keep our reference image on the slider. And this should allow us to generate from that base reference image. So now we are going to change the composition and let's go to a blurry background, change the lighting to dramatic and the color and tone to vibrant. Okay, not really that much of a change. Let's try and change the studio lighting. Again, not much of a change. Okay, let's go shot from above. This should shake things up. Okay, I suspect our issue here is maybe being too precise. So let's drop that back. Let's change things a little bit. Okay, so it's not really giving us too many variables at the moment because we're probably using our reference image too tightly. So we'll drop it right back towards the prompt. Okay, yeah, so that's totally thrown it out the window. So we can expand the image here. Go back to our main ones. Okay, this one's pretty cool. That will be our new reference image. Okay, so we've experimented enough, kind of get the gist of it. If you've used Midjourney or anything else, very similar. They just definitely need to figure out their prompting. So to download your product, just click download. It will enter all the metadata and tag it as an AI image. And we can go across to our downloads and check the quality. So that's our image there. It's actually pretty high quality. We've got our little watermark in the bottom corner here. Let's check out the image details. So that's our dimensions. So 1792 by 1024. Not exactly gigantic. DPI is 96. Bit depth 24. But you can use AI to upscale that again as well. So definitely pretty easy to do. Okay, I think we'll wrap that guide up here. It's pretty straightforward to use. If you've used any of the other platforms, you know what you're doing anyway. It all comes down to your prompt engineering and basically at this stage, what they're going to allow. So as far as I can see, it's a little bit sensitive. Hopefully they do change that, but it is what it is for now. So as always, thanks for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and I'll see you in another video. Cheers, everyone.